What's up guys, this is Igor in Russia and today we're filming a new episode for my Russian Finland episodes. And today we're in Porvoo, which is a beautiful, beautiful old city next to Helsinki. It's about 30 minute drive away. We're gonna dive into the Imperial Russian Finnish history of Diet of Porvoo 1809. Hit that subscribe button, push the notification bell on, leave a comment and share the videos. Much appreciated. So let's go. Welcome guys to our trip to beautiful city of Porvoo, which has a huge importance in Finnish-Russian history, and it marks the beginning of Finnish autonomy and it marks the beginning of Finnish independence. Before that, we decided to head into this Porvoo and Pahtimo. It's a cafe at the edge of old city. It's a must visit place also to get a good cup of coffee. The house is actually very Imperial Russian types. It's built in 1902. Great views and very historical. After a good cup of coffee, we continued marching to heart of old town Porvoo. And Porvoo has an important part of Finnish history, in Finnish history. It's the beginning of autonomous Finland. The 700-year relations between Sweden and Russia ended after the Finnish War 1808 until 1809, when Finland was annexed to Russia as an autonomous Grand Duchy. Alexander I, the Tsar of Russia, convened the Diet of Porvoo in 1809. This was an important cornerstone in the history of Finland, starting the progress towards the independence. As a result of Porvoo Diet, Finland was allowed to keep its religion, its constitution dating from the Swedish era, and the rights of its estates. How is that for a typical depiction of an evil Russia? During the Finnish War between Sweden and Russia, the four estates of Russian-occupied Finland, nobility, clergy, burghers and peasants, were assembled at Porvoo by Tsar Alexander I, the new Grand Prince of Finland, between 25th of March and 19th of July 1809. Each of the estates swore the oaths of allegiance, committing themselves to accepting the Emperor as a Grand Prince of Finland as the true authority and to keeping the constitution and the form of government unchanged. Alexander I promised to govern Finland in accordance with its laws and let the Finnish people keep their religion and rights. The Tsar Alexander I arrived to Porvoo on a cold but sunny day on 27th of March. He arrived to Porvoo on carriages but got off them and mounted a horse outside the city so he can ride them into town. And these carriages are presented at the Porvoo's museum at the moment. Everybody of some importance were meeting the Tsar at the city's honorary gates, especially built for Alexander I, with crafted Russian imperial two-headed eagle on top of it, which was later stolen. The emperor was greeted also with honorary cannon fire and ringing of church bells. After the Alexander I era, the town expanded to the south by the will of next Russian emperor, Nikolai I. Porvoo was then built according to the empire-style Saint Petersburgian plan. Architect Carl Ludwig Engel, who also drew the Senate Square area in Helsinki, was nominated as the designer of a new Porvoo. But now, let's get back to the Alexander I and the year 1809.
Now we have a unique chance to visit the residence of the Tsar. That's the building where the Tsar stayed while being here at the Diet of Porvoo. And we're gonna hear from a local guide, actually the owner of the building. a little bit more about the history. And this building, actually, you can rent it for as an apartment while staying here at Porvoo, in the same building where the Tsar stayed. That's amazing.
The same room.
In the same room where the Tsar stayed. How awesome is that? Joo. Huomenta.
Tämmöinen automatiikka. Morjens.
No niin, tervetuloa tänne vanhaan Porvooseen ja Porvoon linna ja linnan pihalle. Tulitte aika matkalle tänne. Nimittäin tämä talo on ensimmäinen kivitalo, joka rakennettiin 1760 vanhaan Porvooseen, kun vanha Porvoon paloi. Ja tämä oli kauppiaan talo ja kauppias rakensi tämän itselleen. Ja kauppias asui ylhäällä, liikkeet oli alhaalla ja sitten nämä alueella olevat aitat olivat sitten kauppiaan varastoja. No sitten historiassa aina kun Ruotsin kuninkaat tulivat tarkastamaan maita ja mannuja tänne Suomeen, niin heidät majoitettiin tähän taloon. Silloin jo 1700-luvulla tätä paikkaa alettiin kutsumaan linnaksi. Mutta sitten loistoon arvaamattomaan tämä paikka nousi sitten 1809, kun Aleksanteri ensimmäinen tuli Porvooseen nostamaan Suomen kansaksi kansakuntien joukkoon. Ja hänet majoitettiin tähän taloon. Ja näin Aleksanteri ensimmäinen asui tässä talossa. Ja noissa talon päädyistä kukkastiin reijät ja palvelusväki asui tuossa talossa. Ja sitten tuossa toisessa talossa. Ja Aleksanteri itse asui sitten tässä ylhäällä. Ja tästä sitten kirkolle rakennettiin tämmöinen puukäytävä, joka sitten Aleksanteri pääsi kävelemään kirkolle ilman, että hänen jalkansa olivat sitten menneet kastuneet. Ja näin sitten hän asui tässä kaiken kaikkiaan 4 kuukautta, kun hän kiersi ympäri Suomea. Ja sen takia tästä paikasta on tullut tämmöinen venäläisten turistien pyhinvaelluspaikka, että täällä käydään paljon turisteja käy tässä pihalla. Paikkahan kutsutaan myös Remunlinnaksi, eli Suomen rokin kuningas Remu asui tässä 20 vuotta. Tässä 2 vuotta sitten tämä muutettiin Porvoo Castle Apartmentsiksi, eli tässä on vuokralla 2 sviittiä, Aleksanterin sviitti, joka on 125 neliöä, joka on kalustettu siihen 1700-1800-luvun asuun, kun se luultavasti olisi silloin ollut. Ja tämä toinen sviitti on sitten Remun sviitti. Hän on 400, kato huvissa oli 400 ihmistä.
Niin, mistä hän on melkoinen delegaatio.
Oli, silloin kaikki ruuat tuotiin. Tässä hän kestitsi sitten suomalaisia porvareita ja tämmöisiä hän kestitsi tässä näin.
20. Mennään tuonne rantsuun käymään, niin näin.
Maailmassahan on 2 Elvis Presley -boulevardia. Toinen on siellä Memphisissä ja toinen on täällä vanhassa Porvoossa linnan pihalla. Ja tarina kertoo, että vuonna 59, kun Elvis oli Saksassa armeijassa, hän tutustui siellä porvoolaiseen aupairiin. Ja he olisivat rakastuneet, porvoolainen aupairi tuli tänne takaisin Porvooseen, niin Elvis olisi ollut 2 viikkoa näissä aitoissa tämän aupairin kanssa. Ja sen takia tämä on ristitty Elvis Presley Boulevardiksi. Tämä on tarina, jota moni Elvis-tutkija on käynyt täällä katsomassa, mutta totuutta me ei olla vielä saatu.
Right in the backyard of Tsar's residence is a antique shop area with different small shops selling different artwork, books and design. Jari and Aku decided to purchase a couple from which was actually put up on a old toilet area. Well, it's now a gallery, but it used to be a toilet.
the Cathedral of Porvoo was the site of the opening of the first Diet of Finland on 28th of March 1809. So they had the first the opening event here and also the closing event, which was a service on 19th of July 1809. The legendary painting of this Diet of Porvoo by Emmanuel Thelning was actually painted from this event here on the opening ceremony. He actually made some drafts on spots and actually finished the work years later from Helsinki. At this exact spot inside the Porvoo Cathedral, you have a bronze statue of Alexander the First, built in 1909. They had some services going on inside, so they didn't let us in to film it, so we have to just use some pictures you can get on get online. Here's the picture, here's the actual painting, legendary painting of the Diet of Porvoo, of Alexander the First having a speech inside the Porvoo Cathedral, and here's the actual picture from inside at the same location. Wow, beautiful.
We are now in front of the Porvoo City Museum, and it has actually some interesting artifacts inside of it, but this is Finland, it's Sunday, so it's not open. It contains some interesting artifacts from the Diet of Porvoo concerning the Tsar's visit. It also includes a It also includes a very interesting fact. There was a lady from Porvoo who dropped the fan, and Alexander the First took a liking of her, grabbed the fan, held to it for the rest of the evening, and that fan is also in the museum, which is closed. It's an amazing little town. During the summertime, this is must-go place in Finland, especially because of the Russian history and the events. So I definitely recommend you to come by. It's a unique location, 30-minute drive from Helsinki.
And here is a building which at that time was a gymnasium. On its second floor, they held a ball for all the attendees of the Diet of Porvoo. And that would have been something to see. What is amazing about Porvoo is that it has a connection to a third Russian emperor, a Romanov, a former claimant to the Russian imperial throne, Vladimir Kirillovich, Grand Duke of Russia. He was actually born in Porvoo, and this is his birth house. He was the head of the imperial family of Russia, a position in which he claimed from 38 to his death. He was the only son of Grand Duke Kirill Vladimirovich and Grand Duchess Victoria Fedorovna. Vladimir's family had fled to Finland after the Russian Revolution of 1917. His family left Finland in 1920, moving to Germany. On August 22, Vladimir's father declared himself creator of the Russian throne, and 2 years later, on August 24th, his father went a step further and assumed the title Emperor and the Autocrat of all Russias. With his father's assumption to the imperial title, Vladimir was granted the title of Cesarevich, heir apparent and Grand Duke with the style of Imperial Highness. In the 1930s, Vladimir lived for a period in England studying at the University of London. On the death of his father, on October 38, Vladimir assumed the headship of the Imperial family of Russia. In 1938, there were suggestions that he would be made a regent of Ukraine, but he rebuffed the idea, saying he would not help dissolve Russia. After the war, he spent most of his time in Madrid, with frequent stays at his property in Brittany, as well as in Paris. Vladimir was able to visit Russia in 1991, in November, when he was invited to visit Saint Petersburg by its mayor Anatoly Sobchak. Grand Duke Vladimir died while addressing the gathering of Spanish-speaking bankers and investors in Northern Trust Bank Miami in the United States in 1992. His body was returned to Russia and he was buried with the full pomp and splendor in the Peter and Paul Fortress in St. Petersburg, the first Romanov to be honored in this way since before the revolution. The press noted that the funeral was regarded by the civic and Russian authorities as an obligation to the Romanov family rather than a step forward restoration of the monarchy.
This has been an awesome experience here in Porvoo. Thanks for joining in. Click that subscribe button, leave a comment and share the video. I much appreciate. See you guys again on the next episode of Russian Finland.